Hey, what's going on, everybody? It is Sully. We are doing the walkthrough on the Southport 33 DC. Now, in the last video, I showed you guys we're kind of in process getting things going. Well, now we're starting to bring everything online. So take a peek underneath the boat right now. You're going to see we have our pair of midship forward TIX, I believe those are 403 through-haul underwater lights online, up and running. And as we make our way back here, you're gonna start to see a lot of glowing. Why? Because we have a trio of the SMX 153 lights with 1, 2, and 3. And of course, if we're doing the lighting, you gotta do the cowl lighting. What's the point in doing all this and not being able to show up and show out, right? So we've got all of that going on here. That's all online. That is all controlled from our Garmin MFDs with our Lumalink controller. So now we're going to hop on board. I'm going to show you everything that the team has gotten finished and wrapped up on this awesome build for Twin Tails Yachts. So let's go hop on and check it out, guys. All right, so we're going to start at the very back in the bottom of the boat, and we're going to work our way forward on this one. So as we make our way into the bilge, you're going to notice, guys, we have two of our Siren Marine sensors. We've got our high water sensor right there, and then we've got our aft bilge, and that guy is tied in to right there. So those are the wireless sensors from Siren Marine. They go back to the MTC unit, and they allow us to monitor what's going on in the boat. So we've got our battery voltage, our fuel tank levels, bilges, high water, all those kind of things. So it's really pretty handy, pretty slick to have that. So we've got that in there. Also on the back deck here is the first of two of the JL M6 10-inch subs. So we've got those in there, and then you can kind of see the light show still going on, even with all the light in the shop here, just how bright all that lighting is. So as we make our way into the console area, I guess you can say, looking the overhead here, there is the first of four Lumishore lights right there. Then we've got our JL M677. Then we've got another JL M677 with the Lux downlighting right there. And we make our way forward here, another M6. That's a 6.5 because we can't fit a 7 there with the Lumishore light. Another Lumishore downlight and another M6. As we talked about in the last video here, guys, we've gone ahead and all the wood trim on this boat has been sanded down, and we went ahead and the guys went and stained that all black. So it makes for a really nice accent, I think, against the gray. And that includes even on this wood piece down here. I think that turned out really slick and was really a clean way to go with this. So before we go touch off on the helm, let's finish talking about what else is powering all of this JL audio goodness that we have here. So if we take a peek down into the mid-bilge area here, you see two black boxes right there. So there we have a 3-channel amp and the 5-channel amp right there from JL. So those are what are powering this whole sound system. And then talking on the displays and everything else we've got going on, this went with a pair of the Garmin 8600s in here, and those are flush mounted in. And you see we've got our Lumishore control going on right here, so we can control everything right there. But you can see we've also popped up, we've got our Mercury integrated into this, so we can have just a small bar with Mercury cruise control right there, or we can have a big screen like this set up for the Merc as well. So we've got multiple options there. We like to make sure you've got all the availability that you want for any of your data, however you want it, we can do that right there. So if we back out of there, we go into video, then you're gonna come up, we're gonna see we have our FLIR M300. You know, that's my favorite daylight viewable camera. It's been really popular and been really successful for us. And that is tied back in here, guys, to this Garmin Grid remote. Take a look at this Garmin Grid. We get asked about these a lot, and why would you want it? Well, you see this little rotary knob that's on here, guys. If I take that little rotary knob, I go over here to this screen, I now have full control of my FLIR camera. I can zoom, I can pan, I can tilt, I can do all that from right here. So if I'm driving, I'm underway, it's nighttime, I don't want to be focused on my screen or bouncing around, I can just grab this Grid remote, it falls right at hand, right there while I'm driving the boat, and be able to have a great view of my camera, as well as all my other Garmin functions with my MFD with that. So it's just another thing I don't think a lot of people know about with those Grid remotes is you can control your FLIR camera with them. So you don't have to have that FLIR JCU in another remote and giving up more dash space. Speaking of dash space, moving down the line here, we have the new ScanStrut Nano right here. That is a inductive phone charger. So we've got that installed. Now this boat came with the factory switches right here, and you're gonna see this overhead light switch right here. So the boat didn't come with Lumishore lighting. We installed that, right? But we want to be able to not have to add another switch and make it look like it was added on to be able to turn these lights on. So with Lumishore, we're able to create a scene. And once we create a scene, we're able to use a trigger wire and go to a momentary switch. So when I hit the overhead light switch right here, I've told the trigger to go to red. So now I have red lighting here. And I did the same thing for the underwater lights. Now, if I don't like that, I can merely come in here to scenes, and you can see I have two scenes created. If I want to change either one of those scenes, I can very easily set that up. So it's just another reason why we really like using Lumishore. These Lumishore are also tied in to the JL audio on this boat, so we can do lights to music. I'll show you guys that in a second once we get done going up forward. So we're gonna leave here. Oh, almost forgot, guys. This also gets the Vesper Cortex right here. So with that, we're getting AIS and VHF and an anchor monitor and, you know, all that fun stuff that is included with that. So as we make our way up forward here, we get to our forward seating area. You can see in this cubby, you can kind of see that nice glow. That's more Lumishore neon flex. We've got another scan strut charger right here with the inductive charging. That's a JL M677 right there. Then we've got an M6 10-inch sub right there. We kind of peek over the canvas right here. You can see another JL M677 and another charger. So you've got great audio up here. Everybody can charge their phones. There's plenty of connectivity all the way around. Everybody can stay connected, inductive charging, keep their devices ready to go. So that's all squared away there. And then as we take a peek on the hard top here, as I showed you guys the last time, we've got a lot going on up here. We've got our FLIR M300 camera, our 4-foot Phantom open array. We've got a pair of solar panels because this thing lives on a mooring. And then we've got this nice big curved Lumishore light bar. And tucked away behind that is the mushroom farm for all the required GPS antennas. So it's got a lot of cool stuff going on board this boat as I make my way down here. And this has been a fun install. It's been a lot of cool stuff on it. And I wanted to show you one of the other things we got here is we have inductive charging right here as well. We've gone ahead and placed one of those right there. So we've got that as well. So now here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna come in here to one of the other fun features like I just mentioned. Come in here, we go to all zones and we say, hey, let's make this go to music. We make an adjustment on this so that it knows it's going to music. It's going to have all the zones. I hit play over here. There it is, the latest Southport 33 DC for Twin Tails Yachts. You guys want to know more about this, or you want to see sea trials of this boat, stay tuned. Once this boat hits the water this spring, we're going to get out there, we're going to do a nice photo shoot, and get all that performance data for you as well. So be sure to give us a follow to stay up to date and in the know with the latest marine tips, techs, and trends. Thank you guys for tuning in. Peace.